A number of fields are automatically filled out when you're entering an item number on the sales lines. I will go through some of these fields and tell you and why we would update these. Some of the columns shown on my sales line has been added. If these columns are not visible in your Business Central, you should add them using the personalize feature, which you can view in another video how to do. In cross-reference number, if the customer has set up a cross-reference number for this item, this would automatically have been filled in. If there is a cross-reference number, I could also have typed in the customer's item number and it would automatically have filled in my item number. Location code will automatically come from the location on the header, but we can change this if we need parts of the sales order to be shipped from another location. In unit of measure code, we can change between different unit of measures if this item is both sold in pieces and boxes, for example. The unit cost in local currency are set in. In discount line percentage, we can state if there should be discount percentage on the line. If it's set up at the customer, this would automatically be transferred. Likewise with the prepayment percentage, it can either come from the customer card, or we can state here that a prepayment percentage should be added to this sales order line. In quantity to ship, we state how many of these items that should be shipped before posting the shipment. So if we are delivering the order in different shipments, we would decrease the number here before the order has been posted for shipment. Likewise, in the quantity to invoice, we can either invoice all of them or part of them. In planned delivery date, we state when we have planned to deliver the items. In promised delivery date, we state if we have promised the customer to deliver this item on a specific date. In requested delivery date, we state when the customer has requested for the item to be delivered. In outbound handling time, we can state how long it will take for us to handle the warehouse handling time. Planned shipment date, we state when we plan to ship the order. Shipment date is when we ship the item. Here, department and project code are the global dimensions that have come from the item, but I can change this. If the order has been transferred from a blanket order, the blanket order number and blanket order line number would automatically have been filled out.